dead. I'm so dead, you guys. I'm it's gone. I'm gone from the scene forever. Oh, crap. Sorry, my bad, guys. Oh my god, I have to be so careful, y'all. Options. Accept. Return to game. Okay, we did it. Whew. Okay, guys, we didn't mess anything up. But seriously, these are like my two favorite players from their respective races. In Hero, at times, like my favorite player, and at times, TY is like my favorite player, like of all time. So, I'm very, very excited to bring you this TVP in the top left on Stasis. How'd this get through? It is the Red Protoss Hero. In the top right as the Blue Terran, it is Splices TY. Oh my god. So while we watch this all unfold, is they don't have any proxies, although... Oh, I thought that was a double gas. I was incorrect. Yeah, so normal start here. Normal start. I will tell a bit of a story. Not the, you know, back in 2010, this is how the NA scene died story. But rather just the Babby's Omega caster story. I think my first, like, big, like, official pro player tournament type deal was an IEM qualifier back with a guy named Xander Fever. This is getting really old school, guys. And I remember casting, like, the Muslim, who back in, like, 2012-ish, I want to say, was the time. I was just, it was like, oh my god, it was the bee's knees. So it's, like, always been this cool little, like, I don't know. Oh no, the queen server lag's gonna bother us, isn't it? Drat. Can't do anything about that. But anyway, it's always been nice to go back to casting qualifiers at all. Now that everything's kind of changed up and it's mostly WCS qualifiers, it's still really cool to have IEM. But it's just like I would never get over the whole, oh my god, this is actually happening, I think. Because even after casting BlizzCon in 2017, after casting tons of IEM qualifiers previous to this, really, I still get chills. I still get, like, so nervous casting... like these two guys especially, and it just makes me feel like a little girl again. It's just, yeah, good. So there's my fangirl moment. Now you guys know a little bit more about me. Okay, so let's try and educate the people instead of just reveling and watching these guys play, because it's also so cool because I'm sucking versus Protoss right now and I'm just like, TY, show me the way, please, for the love of god. But I think TY is also saying the same things to people he deems better than him at TVP. I think Innovation is doing particularly well against Protoss, especially compared to other Terrans, if I'm remembering correctly. So he's probably like, Innovation, please show me the way. But TY has always had his individual style against all matchups. And you know, a lot of his tank plays that we remember fondly from his past were very positional. So, you know, kind of tank-based, right, and abusive on the map type deal. And even if Innovation was showing the true way, I don't know if TY would even try and follow it, right? So I want to know how TY deals with Protoss. So he went from dealing with discs, kind of like kind of cheesy stuff, right, to now dealing with Hero, who, yes, can be cheesy and all any, but backs it up with extremely good macro and extremely good micro. And that's going to be a very scary thing for TY to deal with. Now we do have an Oracle opener that just goes right for that Reaper kill. So, I mean, it wasn't too worried about really dealing a lot of damage to the SCVs, assuming that TY would have the defense, which TY does, Cyclone included here. I was looking for Kishifiku playing. Okay, I don't know. Sorry, guys. Are you casting Maru at all today? I mean, God, I'll cast any of the Koreans, hopefully, at some point. All of them, but... Believe it or not, some of them are going to knock each other out or be knocked out by the Europeans. Or a couple North Americans, perhaps, before I even get a chance to. So we'll see what happens. Hopefully you guys can start answering some of the you know, repetitive questions. I know people are just, you know, trickling in, and that's totally fine. But hopefully the chat can help me out here and tell people why TY is playing in this tournament. Why is Mana playing this tournament? Why is blah, 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 blah. Oh my god, that is a Fleet Beacon already? Oh. Hero, no. Hero, why would you do this? Why? I'm both ecstatic as well as judging so hard. Of course he once upon finding out that Stasis went through the vetoes, he goes for a Tempest Rush. Of course he does. Why not? This is great. So this isn't as abusive of a map as, say, oh man, I don't even know, like Scrap Station. Remember those, that map, guys? To do a Tempest Rush on, but it's not great. It's not great for the Terran to deal with, so it, and by saying that, I meant that it is still good for Tempest or Carriers or Drops, like, or whatever, right? Like, you got this close by air problem, but the interesting thing about Stasis is that, well, yes, it is still close by air. It's close by air, specifically in your natural. If you try to go from main to main, oh, hold on, let's go this way, you do have air blockers. And TY is currently doing a tank push that I don't even know, like, he did not scout that it was Tempest. He scouted the natural, not the main. Does he think he can deal with this? The Tempest does die a lot quicker, but it also moves a lot quicker. So you would think, ideally, the micro would win out here. And Hero does still have a ground armor to work with this too, but he's already struggling a little bit. Now, he could bait TY into that stasis trap if TY thought that he could maybe find an opening there, but I'm thinking there wouldn't be one. He doesn't have enough cyclones, the Marines don't have stim. So the Tempest do ultimately push this back, but TY is not willing to give up his position quite yet. He wants to engage the ground army and trade at least a little bit, which... is that the right call? I mean, obviously TY thinks so, but it is perhaps overstaying its welcome. Of course the Tempest will be able to chase this thing, these units down with their increased speed. And now even a revelation to help out with their sight means that... TY, I guess, really has to do a dance of looking like he's going to hold his position and also trying to get the heck out of dodge. Good focus fire with the tanks. Oh, that was glorious. Hero knew there was two more tanks there, but still let his sentries go a little too far forward. Again, guys, let me know if things are a little too loud. Or too soft, or whatever. These Tempests are in my ears particularly loud. You guys can't see me, but I'm reducing the volume on my headset. So anyways, very cool start to this game. How does TY handle things from here on out, right? He does this tank push. He wants to at least trade with the army. Ideally, you know, I gotta pull a probe, something like that, something really harsh to deal with it. He doesn't get that. He didn't get the cancel on Nexus. That was like far, you know, that was not really an option. He didn't get a lot of the army, although he got a fair bit. You know, those sentry kills were really, really nice. But he delayed so much in doing that type of attack that was it all really worth it? He has no third command center. It looks like he's just gonna go for a two base all in. He delayed Stim heavily, and he's only working off of one tech lab, so he also has super delayed combat shields, and Marauder Slow is, at least that's a fast upgrade, but it still will be delayed as well, right? If he even goes for Marauders. Euthermal's been doing a very tank-heavy style, but more of a macro base to it. Looks like TY here with his still tank composition is also going to go pure Marine with this. So, I mean, it feels like sometimes it would be nice to have one or two Marauders with Slow, especially against Protoss, where they're all about having... a small amount of units, but really beefy units, right? Because one slow can make a big difference. But when you go for the style, you generally don't get a lot of Marauders or any at all. So we'll see how that works out. I mean, at the end of the day here, as we watch the end of this game perhaps unfold, TY, I feel, just doesn't have a very favorable position. Well, this is so borked, you guys. You can't see the army supply. Well, I already changed the overlay, so it'll be fixed next time. So anyways... it feels like he just has such a bad position to begin with. I'm not even sure a two base all in is going to work out here. Because it's not even about dealing with the ground arm anymore, right? Where you could always say, oh, he's going to find an abusive position with the tanks. He has to deal with five Tempests at this point. Storm's about to finish. No way he's going to get to Ghost. He has to hope that the High Templars run into the tank fire. Because he can't even really micro against them with Marauders. Again, no Marauders. But it could happen. You don't usually see these type of engagements go down, but we're here seeing it here in Hero versus TY. The Marines are already splitting up a little bit. The left side gets demolished by the storms. He could have maybe picked up, but is choosing just to split. On the right side, though, the tanks were not able to blast away up the High Templars. The Marines were trying to catch up to those Tempests. But is it really possible for TY to deal with this? Medivacs could also be targeted here, but it looks like just the entire army of TY is going to go down. Not enough Marines take on these Tempests. More coming from the right side, but Okay, they're gonna get one, not even. They just pulled back. GG. Hero. Taking game number one here on Stasis. I'm really surprised that... I guess not. I personally don't like Stasis, but the more I think about it, the more opportunities there are to abuse tanks. Positional, right, advantages, which is kind of what TY is all about. So I can see why it was let through, but I think TY is now realizing why, you know, maybe Hero chose it first. I'm not sure. Actually, I think Hero does have the higher seed, so he might have chosen it first. But you get my drift. Like, basically, TY is like, oh, that sucked. Bomb is perfect. Oh, cool. Great. Wow, you guys just heard the battlecruiser in the background. Isn't it loud? Get out of here, battlecruiser! It was perfectly timed up with the countdown, by the way. Alright, Skin War 2. Now we have the proper overlay as well. Let's move this back to its concern location. I'm gonna have to remember to do that for Europe if I ever cast European versus European. Which I can almost guarantee I won't remember to do. Almost guaranteed. Slip on. Lippity script. The top right, up one. Now on blue shift, it is the red Protoss Hero. In the bottom left, there's the blue Terran. He is Splice TY. And he has said F it to the whole macro idea and is sending out that SCV to proxy. Now, I could do a whole shebang about why proxies are involved here, why they've been popular for the last year and a half, why they're still popular, why the patch didn't fix anything, although people were really hoping that it would. I mean, there's just so much to talk about, but TLDR, proxies are basically what all Terrans seem to agree on they have to do to keep things at least even going into the mid and especially into the late game. Mid-game tank pushes don't do as much. It seems that the Protoss, once they get wind or something like that, they have options, I should say. I'm trying not to sound biased, even though I'm repeating things that other better Terrans have said. I don't want to include any bias they might have. They might have options to deal with it without sacrificing too much of their own. Late game is always been very tough when the Protoss gets to the perfect late-game composition, right? We all know what a scary death ball that can be, and... a lot of Terrans feel that they just simply can't handle that composition or keep up with the amount of harassment options and whatnot that exists with the Warp Prism and DTs and so on and so forth. So you start things off nice and quick. You might even get a very quick tied up score if you really invest into this. So we do see TY going for the factory as well as the proxy barracks and is going to go ahead and swap it off to get to Cyclones. Now, Hero did not probe scout in this game. Very weird choice. Almost every single Protoss scouts with a probe nowadays. There's so many things that you can get from scouting not even just scouting, right? Like, we all know how annoying it can be to watch a probe almost kill three SCVs. Usually it's just a why don't you use a probe? And the reason that probes are so easy to use is because, you know, they don't have to sacrifice, quote-unquote, a worker to build something. They plop it down and they leave. So it's really like a why not? Well, in this game, Hero doesn't bother. So Hero did go, and this was perhaps why he didn't bother, he did go for a one base Stargate opener and is now, only now getting the Nexus. So we'll have that little bit of added production, and just in general, right, he'll have the units faster. He's also now scouted the lack of natural and the wall of the supply depots, so he knows that it's not a simple barracks proxy, it should be a factory one as well, and is adding on a shield battery and another gateway. This Nexus, I think you let it finish. It is pretty dedicated from the Terran player that this could at least buy time, even if you do end up losing it. But if you don't lose it, then the Terran's really SOL. Oracle does particularly well against the Cyclone, especially if the Cyclone has just used its lock-on on something more useless like an Adept. And things are not starting off very well. It looks like Hero really read in appropriately to what TY would follow up a macro game with. Well, two base all in macro game, but still, and has just simply smacked it across the face, like, really, really bad. Oh, things are not, I don't feel so good, guys, for TY. I don't feel so good. This opener was particularly devastating. You know, there's nothing prior, there's no Reaper made to even scout. This is the case that maybe TY could go, oh, just kidding, I'm not gonna invest into this. No, he did it, he invested into it. I was talking about Hero's lack of scouting as opposed to TY. Was a little late to seeing the Stargate as well, which is now with the barracks, right? And TY has to think about all these options he has to potentially do damage, and unfortunately the options are limited. I mean, the Banshee shouldn't do anything. There are, what, three oracles now? Three oracles that can cast Revelation. At least three, right, is the idea. So even if you waited a long time to show the Banshees for a surprise, aha, gotcha, there'd still be detection. Shieldbiters are also in the mineral line, so you'd have to wait for two anyways to get actual probe damage, and Phoenixes will demolish Phoenix or Banshees very quickly, so it's just... I'm not sure what TY is going to do to pull this win out of his sleeves, I guess I'll say, because it's not looking good. Hero's up 11 workers, which, okay, but TY doesn't have a natural, so it's definitely bad. TY is going to start siege hopping forward. This feels... It might be something he's practiced before, but it's probably not something he practices often. It's probably not the point of the reason that he proxies. So I'm not sure how this is going to look. I'm guessing not good. The Phoenix count alone, getting up to 3 or 4, will be able to lift up all of TY's army. or take out the Banshee so fast they won't contribute, like, either way, right? Oh, no. I don't know. Like, even if he made a tank right now, which he could, right? There's a tech lab on the factory. And hope to draw Hero out to him by slowly siege hopping. The Phoenix, again, would be a good choice just to lift that up. He doesn't have enough, like, I keep talking about the Phoenix as if he has a billion of them and it's easy, but they're such good anchors with the rest of the army that Hero has. This one starts coming down. He knows that the Phoenix weren't here, he'd have a shot. He'd be able to potentially start chipping away at the army bit by bit, lock on by lock on. But with the Phoenix, anytime he does that, he could be lifted up. So that's why we have so many missile turrets on the way. But it looks like it's not going to be enough. Even flying past all these missile turrets, Hero's able to do enough damage to the Cyclones. So much of his ground army is left over, and TY was truly desperate after the first Cyclone didn't work. GG. Not exactly the games I was hoping for, but Hero looked way too good. Or way too abusive. It depends on your point of view, I suppose.